a little bit of a follow-up on my rant about hating Japanese pop music. Raymond, if you'll indulge me.
Yeah, okay.
All right. We mentioned last time that a lot of Japanese pop outfits make up meaningless names, i.e. SMAP.
Yep.
Or I can't even pronounce some of these.
It doesn't even have to be pop. It can be any band, basically.
Yes, it could be any, yeah.
But the rock band, Bump of Chicken.
There's that one.
Baseball Bear.
Is that a real one?
Yep.
Ogre You Asshole. Actually, that name comes from Meatballs, right? Yeah. Or Revenge of the Nerds.
Yeah, yeah.
Which I actually think is kind of funny now that I think about it.
Not a bad band either.
Yeah?
No.
Well, there's one. I saw a billboard for the new album for a band. I'm going to give you the letters. I'm going to spell out the band's name, and I want you to try to pronounce it.
Okay.
All right.
You're going to spell it out.
I'm going to spell it out. Here we go. KIS hyphen MY hyphen FT2.
Okay. Well, I guess, you know, the obvious one would be Kiss My Feet 2.
Close enough. It is Kiss My Foot 2.
Okay. Oh, wow.
Is the name of an actual Japanese boy band.
Okay. Kiss My Foot 2.
Kiss My Foot 2. How do you think they arrived at that name?
Let's see. Well, I'll start from the back. So let's say there's two members.
There's, I believe, eight members.
Oh, fuck. Okay, well,
I'm sorry.
It's a multiple of two.
Sure, okay, close enough.
Okay, right. Okay.
Right?
I mean, the two is, like, not to the second power or anything, right?
It's no, it's as if this is the sequel to Kiss My Foot.
Right, okay.
All right.
So Kiss My Foot, I would like to think it's like a Donkey Kong situation where someone tried to look up like a nice English romantic phrase in some sort of dictionary and it was translated weird to like kiss my foot.
Hey, kiss my foot.
Hey, sit on it.
Hey, stand on them because they're your feet and you use them to stand.
That's the theory, leading theory in my head right now.
Well,
do you have any insight?
Well, it's a very common Japanese thing. They just took parts of all the members' names and combined them. In this case, the first letter of all their family names. Yeah, and one of them is a robot and has a two in his name.
Yes.
No, the two actually R2. Comes from... Because his... yeah. His last name starts with a knee, so they thought, let's... We can't do anything with an N in there, so let's turn it into two. Because two knee is Japanese for two.
And they're, please tell me they're not popular.
I think they might be because I've seen them downtown on billboards. I've seen them in Sakai. They have this annoying music truck that all it does is drive through Sakai blaring pop music.
Well, that doesn't. Yeah, I mean, if they were super popular, they wouldn't have to do that. Right, they wouldn't have to bring out the truck.
Well, no, I mean, they have to be promoted, and obviously they can afford to do this. I looked them up on Wikipedia after I was boggling the name in my mind all afternoon the other day.
Yeah.
And it's this talent agency, I think, called Johnny's Jr., which also make delicious burgers, by the way.
I'm familiar with them, actually, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
And
they
handle all
male clients, right?
Yeah, yeah, all the... You know, all your boy bands, your teen heartthrobs.
Yes, all the cute boys that skirt, some of them skirt pedophilia lines.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I guess they've only been around a couple years because the article mentioned that they were supposed to debut.
The band.
What?
The band?
Yeah, the band. They were supposed to debut around the time of the earthquake and tsunami disaster of 2011, but because of that, it was pushed back. So
they've only been
around a couple years.
Yeah.
How can you have such a dumb, nearly unpronounceable name and last 2 years?
Well, Prince had his name as a symbol for a few years. And
I know, but he was already established as Prince.
Yeah, but he kept going, too. I mean,
yeah,
it could have been worse. I mean, people did laugh at him for doing that.
Well, yeah, but he, you know, he's the kind of guy where he doesn't give a shit when people laugh at him. He just keeps on going with a straight face.
Yeah.
That's why he's Prince, Ray.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're right, but he's also
That's why
crazy.
We still can't get him on the goddamn show.
No. He doesn't, what, he doesn't believe in the internet or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He says the internet is over.
Yeah.
Yes. The episode title even writes itself, Purple Rayton. Come on.
I'd rather you didn't.
No?
Oh, wait, I'm editing this week, so it doesn't matter.
Aw, oh, damn it.
Aha!
You're probably going to make me say something stupid like, I love cocks.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's no more Whoppers. Hi. I promise I won't do that sing-songy anymore.
Please.
My name is Ray Barnhold, Pantsmaster, and with me as always, April showers bring May Fraoli. it's Alex Fraoli.
Ah, geez, I'm soaked to the gills here.
Yeah, you don't have to play around with that one. That was
April showers. trying to help you out here.
No, just don't.
Yeah, my sidekick fucking sucks!
All right! You okay?
I was mocking the end of that one.
Just cut out the whole thing, then. I love cocks.
But yeah, I'm very tired this week, so. Today.
What happened?
I mean, not the entire week, but.
What happened, Ray? Talk to me.
I can't tell you.
Why?
On the air.
Okay. All right, I'll hang up. I'll take my answer off the air, then.
All right.
All right, I'm hanging up.
All right, we'll be back after this.
All right, commercial goes here. Hi, I'm Alex for off.
The mosquito spray?
Yeah.
Okay, I thought you meant just turning things off in general.
I don't think that needs a spokesman.
I'm Alex for the off state on
You
anything.
Know, sometimes it feels like you've been doing something for too long.
Yeah.
Use that opportunity to reach for the switch.
The ad council. Okay.
The ad council. All right, yeah, it's been an exciting week here.
Yeah.
In the land of Japan. Sorry.
Please. Alex.
Hi.
What's up?
Great. I've had one sip of coffee.
Oh, can I say something? I'm sorry.
Go.
Before I start.
Yes.
As we record today, the Retronauts Kickstarter is ended. And we're funded. And we're going to Hollywood.
Wait a minute.
Yep. That's American Idol. I apologize.
But you made like 56K, is that right?
Yeah, almost 57. It was like 56,700 something.
And your original target was $12,000.
Yes.
You're gods now. You're kings among men.
Well, it's not that much money, really.
Now you can retire. You don't even have to do the podcast because like, you already have the money, right?
No. It doesn't work that way.
Right?
No,
I don't understand. No.
We went over this 2 times already. Kickstarter takes a cut and Amazon takes a cut. So it's not going to be that entire amount of money.
Kickstarter!
Anyway, I'm not really mad.
Oh.
But I also wanted to add that the Scroll Kickstarter, I think by the time this episode comes out, still has 3 days on it.
Kickstarter!
So I don't know where that will be at that time, but it will probably be funded unless everyone backs out, right? But
anyway. Oh, that wouldn't happen.
Either way, listen back to last week if you want to get the gist on that. Scroll issue 10. It's going to be a fun one.
Pretty exciting.
Maybe now would be a good time for me to rant about Kickstarter people.
Kickstarter! People.
Yeah, okay.
Go for it. What do you mean?
It'll be our second show. I don't mean anything too specific, but just the general sorts of people who really don't like Kickstarter, basically. And will always come out with these really knee-jerk reactionary sort of comments to anything on there. And it's just really weird. So, I mean, when Retronauts started, it was a bunch of people saying, well, can't they just do this on Skype? They can do this for free. What do they need all this money for? What's all this about? I mean, God,
I don't understand.
Tons of podcasts that use Skype all the time and they're fine.
I don't understand how people's time works and energy.
Yes, exactly. And then I got a couple comments about the Scroll one. Not as many vocal assholes, thank God. But people who were like, oh, this is like a free vacation for Ray sort of thing.
Huh.
And people who also said, can't he just do this interview over Skype? Can he just interview that guy over Skype and whatever? And it's just a general sort of attitude that comes from people where it's just like you're not allowed to do anything special. You know?
Yeah. I like the idea that these people think that they're correcting you and like
yes.
give you no,
yeah.
Ray, wait a minute. Hey, emergency, you don't have to do this. You can just do it over Skype. You didn't know that? Shut up.
Yeah. But I'm just like, am I not allowed to do something special? I mean, are those who are interested and like what I'm doing not allowed to recognize how special it is and then contribute and then get something back? I mean, is that really a problem for you? Is that something that's really going to affect you? Because I'm not trying to scam anybody.
And shitface, look at the Kickstarter. It met its goal. It means people are excited for Ray to do that thing.
Yes.
They're clearly willing to support it.
But, yeah. But like I said, I'm not trying to scam anybody, but there are, like, people who you usually hear about Kickstarter, I think those type of people usually hear about the bad things where people do try and scam people and, you know, or just otherwise, like, super failed campaigns that don't work or otherwise don't sound all that legit.
What was the Penny Arcade one? It's like, give us a whole bunch of money and we'll take ads off our site.
Yeah, basically. And
what
then
the hell?
And all the rewards are really jokey and stuff. Well, I mean, that's legitimate bullshit because also Kickstarter should have really realized that that was all jokey and probably shouldn't have even approved that one.
Was that entire thing a joke?
It was jokey.
I know, but I think was maybe, it a serious Kickstarter?
Well, I think maybe their goal was real and that they would probably take ads.
Okay.
But the way they wrote it and went about it is just their usual Penny Arcade bullshit way.
So. Yeah.
They didn't really. It was it just came off as usual, holier than thou sort of thing.
Yeah.
So things like that I can understand don't really color people's view of Kickstarter that well.
I forgot.
Kickstarter.
Yeah.
Anytime. I love cocks.
That doesn't help either.
Ah, man.
So yeah, I don't get it. The entire point of Kickstarter is that so people can have these creative projects and do something special.
Yeah.
And ask people for help. And if those people want to help and are interested, then please, yes, go ahead. That's the entire point of the site.
I think as usual, as usual, it's just assholes on the internet who are selectively missing the point yet again.
Not even selectively, just like deciding not to get the point.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, just purely not even just like, no, that's bullshit. I've already decided.
I know a better way.
Yeah. I haven't actually been to Kickstarter. I haven't actually read the How It Works link or anything like that. I'll just read about this forum post where somebody made some fake campaign for something and then tried to scam people out of their money. And that's going to just be my entire view of it. And, you know, also... What they also usually hear about Kickstarter is either sort of failures like that or like the huge, huge successes. Like when Double Fine started their adventure game and they got like over $1 million for that.
Yeah.
And then other $1 million ones that came along after that. And it's just like...
$1 million baby.
People think it's, you know, it's either that extreme. You either get a whole bunch of money or you're just evil.
You know how there's like an adult equivalent to everything on the internet? Like YouTube has you porn. Do you think there's a Dickstarter?
Yeah, I mean, we've joked about that. And I think
we have?
One of my friends even made that domain.
Oh, man.
Or at least the logo. Yeah. Sorry, Alex.
Damn it!
I apologize that you couldn't win that one.
All right, can I announce my news? I got news.
Yes, you have a Kickstarter.
I have a Kickstarter. I think it's right over here.
Alex?
Where are you? What? You're in a tunnel.
Kickstarter!
Boy, it's dark in here.
Brilliant. $56,000.
Alex?
Jesus Christ. Oh, no, I'm being assaulted in the tunnel.
Okay, we just... No, please. Please tell us your news.
Good for you!
All right. Folks, after a couple of weeks of efforts and talks and other things,
Diplomacy talks?
Yes. We sat down. We hashed it all out. I've reached an agreement with a fine young woman who is now my girlfriend. We've been dating for almost a week.
Okay.
About a week, sure. No,
that's great, yes.
Yeah, it's not...
Elaine's in love with the whiz guy?
There we go, exactly.
No, yeah.
It's fun. I have not actually been in a real honest-to-goodness relationship in a couple years.
Yeah.
She's smart and cute and funny. And isn't that the trifecta?
Mostly, yeah.
Her name is Mayumi, and she's amazing.
All right, great.
And that's it.
I'm happy for you, bro.
Thanks, brah.
Seems like a real winner, man.
Yeah, yeah. Like you really please
hit one out of the park.
Please, man. I am gonna hang up if you keep doing that voice,
bro.
That is offensive.
Absolute zero.
Yes.
It really does offend you?
Yes.
Then I'll keep it up.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mayumi and I went to Genesis last night. I went to show her around the place. You know.
It's not your bar.
I know. But, you know, it's
it's a place where everybody knows your name.
Exactly.
As opposed to the other five places that also know your name.
Alex?
Yes.
Now, does she like games?
Including the tunnel bar.
Alex?
In any sort of capacity?
No, zero.
Okay.
But she was not...
Absolute zero!
Thank you. Absolute zero. She was not against the idea of playing games, so maybe she'll start playing 75. For some reason, she owns a copy of New Super Mario Brothers on the DS.
Well, who doesn't?
But does not own a DS.
Yeah. Oh, well.
So I loaned her my DS, and hopefully she'll enjoy some of that.
Okay, great.
And Dragon Quest IV, but maybe that's a little bit too much to start off with.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks, Iwata.
Yeah.
That was great.
All right. Well. All
right. I know it sounds kind of premature to announce that kind of thing after a week, but it's like, I don't know. Usually, you've heard No More Whoppers before.
Yeah.
I'll like announce when I meet a girl at the bar, and like that's a big thing. So, and really, I've been sort of holding back on that.
Yeah.
For the past month or so.
Because also, when you say that, it dies on the vine.
You mean I'm like jinxing myself?
No. I just mean you never give any more details and it just sort of like peters out.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I met this girl at a bar and then next week on the show, nothing.
Yeah, well, because usually it's just talking and then I either don't get a number or I get a number and I lose it.
Yes.
Or whatever, you know. But this
or it's
is the
just
first
surreptitiously
time that
slipped into your coat and you completely forget about it.
Yeah.
For a week.
But this is the
end.
First time that thing has actually evolved into an honest-to-goodness relationship. So, very excited.
Okay, yeah.
Things are looking up.
Things are coming up, Alex.
Thanks. Oh, Alex! Yeah. Jesus! It's really loud. In other good news, I have a lot more money in my bank account than I thought I did.
All right. Wow.
I got... Well, here's
things
the thing.
Are coming up, Alex.
I know. Damn it! Fucking...
Please get to you.
I'm right.
I'm going to keep you in this tunnel until you apologize. You just wait right here.
I'll be there for you.
That's right. You're not going anywhere.
I'll be there for you.
All right.
Can I have some trail mix? Almost done with season 4.
Sit down. Anyway. I got my last paycheck from my former company. As of now, all ties are severed with them. All
right.
And I was expecting it to be a lot less because when you leave the company, they send you this...
Absolute zero!
What is wrong with you? Jesus. When you leave the company... Jeez, fuck. They give you this packet of legal information, and one of them is like, we're taking all of your residency tax for the rest of the year out of your last paycheck.
Oh.
And I'm like, damn, all right, I guess it's going to be a small paycheck.
Yeah.
And I got it, and it was almost nothing taken out.
Oh, okay, great.
And, of course, no rent was taken out because I no longer live there.
Yeah.
And I got a bonus, believe it or not. Yeah. I actually got a bonus at the end of my... I guess when you finish every year after the first year, you get a bonus. I thought it was just every other year.
Okay.
But it's not, and that's great. So now I was very worried about money... Before I moved, now I am much less worried.
Yeah.
Good for you! Thanks.
Good for you!
I think I'm going to keep this echo filter on. This is fun.
No, please, no. It's not fun.
What, Ray? Wait, do you have a band in there? Knock it off!
It's just my cousin Hector.
I love that the echo...
Yeah.
The echo actually makes it sound like somebody has sheepishly stopped playing. Knock it off in there, you two!
Yeah, that was really actually... Yeah, that was pretty good.
Okay. All right.
All right. Wait, do you want to say anything else about the young woman, or is that... How could
this happen? Oh, damn it. Oh, no.
How'd you meet?
She's the manager at the part-time job that I have. The Wiz.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, right, right. Yeah, The Wiz. Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody beats it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm mm-hmm. The Wiz.
Yeah,
right. It's me.
Do you really want this?
Yes.
I'm The Wiz!
There we go.
Elaine's in love with The Wiz guy?
Yes. I should mention her name is Elaine. Mayumi Elaine. That's the name.
That's okay.
No, she's fantastic. You may have seen some dumb photos of us already on the Twitter.
Hopefully not the No More Whoppers Twitter.
No, not yet.
That'd be hilarious if you started retweeting yourself and all your personal tweets. Alex, are you there?
I was actually texting Miami.
Oh my god.
She sent me a picture of her friend. She's having lunch with her friend right now. They're having monjayaki.
All right, great.
I got a picture. Now I'm hungry for monjayaki.
Now I have to deal with this every week. Got this woman muscling in, taking away attention from the podcast.
Who's this?
It's Daniel, remember?
Oh, Dan!
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, so that's relationship news. I'm very, very happy for that. Very excited.
Okay.
I've got a flurry of other newses. I also have, Raymond, I also have a No More Whoppers memory. Just one this week, but I'm saving it for segment two.
Well, I have one this week, too.
Well,
only one.
Let's hear it. Oh, shit.
Shall I go ahead and play this week's No More Whoppers memory?
Yeah, go for it.
All right. No More Whoppers memories.
Have you seen the trailer for Wreck-It Ralph?
I don't know what that is.
This has been a No More Whoppers memory.
Oh. It sounds like you're saying Wreck-It Ralph.
Okay, whatever.
Is that not what you were saying?
No, it's not what I was saying.
All right.
Alex.
Hi.
Have you been getting drunk lately?
Yes. Next question.
All right.
They got these big chewy pretzels here that are, oh, you guys.
$5? Get out of here. Actually, yeah, I went drinking with Finbar. My ex-priest senpai, my ex-priest. Yeah. Boy, can you imagine the kind of guy that has an ex-priest?
Oh boy, I can't imagine.
Well, we were priest and what's the word for not audience? Constituent? Congregation, I guess. We were priest and parishioner. Is that it? Parishioner.
You should probably know what the terms are by now if you're going to take that job with.
We were priest and parishioner for a few years, but it just wasn't working out between us.
Yeah, right.
I think I prefer constituent.
Delegates.
Oh, who are you voting for priest?
He's from one of the swing states. Go either way.
Yeah, all right.
So, yeah, Finbar, how's he?
Good. He gave me the script for the ceremony.
All right.
And the handbook, the employee handbook. It seems that about 90% of that job is just showing up on time in a nice suit, looking good. And the other 10% is just reading from the script during the thing.
So in other words, Joel McHale on Talk Soup.
Yes. Oh, I thought you were introducing him.
I'm Alex.
Did that fall through?
It fell. It's okay. Whatever.
But yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I've got a test, I guess, on the 28th. I've got to perform in front of the boss man.
You're cheating on your conversion test?
I had to.
Yeah, it's not really a test, I guess. It's just a performance. And honestly, it's not like they can refuse me because they're kind of desperate for people right now. But, you know, at the same time, I don't want to take advantage of that. I don't want to be a half-ass priest.
No, of course not.
I'm still in this. I'm in it to win it for God. Right?
Kind of, I guess, if I have to.
Oh, Finbar also told me I should start asking for business receipts when I go out and do anything related to work at all.
Wow.
because I can comp stuff. I'm excited for that. Yeah. So I picked up my very first business receipt. Japanese. It's called Yoshu Show. Picked up my Yoshu Show at the bar we went to, and that was it.
Wait, is it actually a separate receipt for business?
It's a separate receipt for write-offs.
Oh wow. Okay. So organized, that country.
I know, but you have to ask for it specifically.
Right, okay.
I almost asked for one yesterday when I bought the Dragon Quest VII strategy guide. Just because I will probably put it in the bar.
This is my Bible.
Yeah. Oh, I should bring that to weddings.
Yes. Why not? And now we will read from...
the new version of a game called Dragon Quest.
Draki's letter to the Corinthians.
Golem 317.
Do you, Maribel, take Gabbo as your lawfully leaded wolf?
Hargon 415.
Leaded or unleaded?
And now from the book of Kobe's journey.
Monsters everywhere.
Okay, let's not drag this out too much. We can have a lot of fun with this, but...
The word of the Lord. The word of the Dragon Lord.
Once again, a rich vein. This is turning out to be for us.
Oh.
We should probably just do like a side podcast that's just like an hour of us riffing on your priest stuff.
Yes! Oh, what would we call it?
Sitting in the pew.
Priest bound and down.
With Alex and Ray.
I think yes, yes.
All right, it's decided. I bought that guide. It was expensive. I mean, it's almost 2,000 yen, but it's a really thick guide. It's like I'm just going to say 2 inches thick.
Yeah, more cushion for the pushing.
Whoa. And I also, while I was there, I bought an issue of the Yotsubato manga. I'm a big fan of that. It's really the only manga that I read ever. I was looking for the new volume that I don't have, number 12, but I decided to start buying them from the beginning because I'd like to own them, so I bought number 1. I was borrowing them from a friend before.
Weird.
I know.
Paper books.
I know.
Give it a rest, Grandpa.
I'm Alex.
Yeah.
Right. Oh wait, are we bringing back the reason the Werther's original?
No,
grandfather?
No. Can we do that? Okay. No.
No.
No. It's okay.
I love my manga. Topanga?
I think.
No. No.
Bazinga.
So, any other highlights from the life of Al? Anything else Dragon Quest related?
Nope. DQ 10 and 10 returned last week. I'm about to record the first installment of the new 10 and 10. After these messages, I'm Alex for Werther's Original.
After these messages, I'll be right back.
Light bright.
Okay, that's all right.
My buddy.
The new version of
10 and 10.
Look forward to it!
You know, you're revisiting a lot of plot threads that were left dangling in the interim.
That's true. Please forgive me all. The whole please forgive me all storyline.
Yeah. You got to wrap that up.
I know. I really want to.
This is like Breaking Bad Season 5 Part 2 here. I mean, you're giving us like a year gap.
I know.
It's not really a year, but I mean, it feels like it. You got to step it up. The public demands to know.
I'm on the case.
Could you also tell us what happens in Breaking Bad Season 5? Well, just like give us an update at the end of everything.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Here's what happened. Walter White opens an outpost. He opens up his own like haven for drug dealers called Methlehem.
Uh huh.
That's all I've got.
Okay.
Oh, and he finds out that his cancer was actually just, like, he had, like, a thing stuck in his teeth. No?
He just had some corn in there.
Yeah. Gave a false positive, it happens.
You just needed to get one of those floss picks. And
yeah. Oh, I hate those.
You hate them?
I want regular floss. Don't give me that pick crap.
Okay.
It has much less mobility.
It has a satisfactory amount of mobility.
Do I have to show you?
Fight about this now?
Yes.
Jesus Christ. They're fine.
Who's the bigger floss enthusiast? Me.
Probably.
Go back to your meth.
You have a humongous floss collection.
Yes.
Dating back to the 1930s.
The world's biggest ball of floss.
Yeah.
I mentioned in a lesson yesterday how when I was a kid, I used to keep a chewed gum collection behind my dresser.
Is that true?
Every time I finished a piece of gum, I would stick it on the back of my dresser and until it got huge. And one day, my mom found it, and she was like, "What the hell is this?"
Yeah, that would be my reaction.
And I'm like, "That's my collection, Mom."
But right now, my reaction is just like, I don't think we can be friends.
Oh, come on. It's gum. You know, gum is up.
No, not this time.
No?
Gum is down.
Gum is down.
Gum is way down.
Gum is way down.
Shots fired. Gum is down.
Oh, God. Right in the sweet spot.
Sorry. May have been watching that manhunt too much this week.
Oh, Officer Gum. Poor Officer Gum.
Oh, no.
Cut down in the prime of his gum. Activist call for gum control.
He still had some flavor in him.
He was 2 days from retirement.
Or what we just call complete flavor loss. He was 2 days from being spat out. And properly disposed of.
Oh, there's a TV show, Mouth Cops. It's just, it all takes place inside a mouth.
I think that was Osmosis Jones.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Well, we're doing great so far.
We are. Do you think we should take a break?
Probably. Maybe we should
All right.
Leave them wanting more, as they say.
That's, well, I don't know if that's going to happen.
Okay.
Let's take a break and be right back.
All right, let's do that.
Alex?
Folks, we're back. It's No More Whoppers. Someone is Ray. Someone is Alex. No one's leaving the house until we figure this out.
I thought we could make it into a contest.
Well, no, I was trying to make it like a murder mystery night.
The listeners could guess who it is. Guess who's who.
Someone in this room is Alex.
You pan around the room, and everybody has a blank face except for my giant smiling grin.
Yeah. I'm Alex!
Oh, you didn't. You weren't supposed to say it.
Oh, I just get so excited. Yes! Raymond,
are you the murderer?
Yes! Oh, damn it.
What? Fuck you!
I've prepared a No More Whoppers memory for this episode. If you'd like to hear it, I'd like to play it.
Yeah, I guess I'd like to hear it. Yeah. Go ahead. No More Whoppers memories. What if the Wonka Candy Company made a candy called anal beads?
Wait, how do you spell beads?
B-E-A-D-S.
I'm kidding. I would eat them.
This has been a No More Whoppers memory. That is like almost every exchange I have with you.
Yeah.
Just drag it out until you finally answer me like a normal person. Jesus.
Right, that was
you got a friend in me. What? Fuck you!
All right, thanks for that. Folks, it's time.
You hate it.
I know. I'm trying to move the segment along. I don't know how.
Thanks to Alex. Great. Hey.
Alex!
Good job.
Yeah.
All right. I got a report. I said last week I was going to check out that burn situation. I noticed that they were putting
the energy drink.
Yeah.
You haven't been burned.
Not committing arson, no.
No.
I
went
to
a children's hospital.
Last week, I noticed that on the energy drink burn, that now has like a pink stripe on it, and it says berry flavor. Oh. And I'm like, oh, is that a new flavor? And so I tried one. It tasted exactly the same. It is exactly the same as the original burn.
All right, great.
Here's what I think happened. Now it goes black and white, and I explain the murder like a monk does.
Hold on.
I think that they had to specify the berry flavor because I think they're trying to differentiate this product from coffee because the packaging is strikingly similar to every canned coffee.
Okay, well,
it's a dark can. It's about the same size, and it has a big flame on it. That looks like most of the coffees.
Okay.
I think they're just trying to make it stand out and say, it's an energy drink. It's not coffee.
So it could be like a rebranding.
That's what I think it is, yes.
Let's make it explicit that this is the berry flavor.
Yes.
Yeah. There was a pink stripe on it.
Yes.
It's not like in support of breast cancer.
I did not read further. It's possible.
Okay.
Or maybe, I don't know. Wait, cans don't get cancer, do they?
No, it's not about... No.
Not talking about colon cancer.
No, not that, just... Cans don't have colons.
Well, I don't know what else butt cancer would be. Why'd you even bring this up?
I was looking for a lead. That's all. Yes, I brought the canine unit.
Get them, boys.
I thought you were going to play it again.
I was. But I was in Notepad, and now there's an extra 5 at the end of my paragraph. Oh, no.
Okay, well, I'm glad that's settled.
What crime am I guilty of?
Hey, I'm just trying to be Italian.
Oh, boy. Yeah. I don't have any energy drink news on my end. No. Although today I had a bubble tea. That was nice. I hadn't had that in a while.
Cool.
Actually, it was a bubble coffee.
Sure.
It was an iced mocha with the pearls at the bottom. Still good. Don't get me wrong. Still good.
Don't get me started.
I was just wanting more of a coffee.
You're a coffee kind of guy.
Well, no, actually, I'm not. I'm just.
Oh.
I mean, for one thing, caffeine doesn't affect me, but also.
Here we go.
I just don't like hot drinks that much. I'm too much of a thirsty person by nature, so I prefer cold drinks. Perhaps I've said this on the show before, but, you know, that's just me. So if I get coffee, it's usually iced coffee or a frappuccino, although apparently people will turn your nose up at you if you get one, but whatever.
Do go on. This is fucking fascinating. Japan? What does Japan have to do with this?
Did I tell you I'm Italian?
That's better. All right, Raymond, if you'll indulge me, I've got some media roundup.
Yep, okay.
Starting with everyone's favorite, Monkments. It's jungle out there. Thank you. If you'll remember... Hang on.
Jesus Christ.
Probably should have planned this better. There was this character who lives above Monk named Kevin.
Nope,
who
don't I remember.
Appeared. He's very forgettable in season 2 or 3. And the whole basis for the episode he appeared in was that he won the lottery. He didn't know it yet. The woman who sold him the ticket knew that he had won, so she was faking a relationship with him, and she was then going to marry him and kill him and keep the money.
Classic.
Eventually, Monk solves the case. Kevin wins the lottery, and he realizes she just wanted the money, so you know he's rich, and he's Kevin. He's a rich guy. He won the lottery.
Right, cha-ching, the end.
Cha-ching, yeah, the end. So I thought. Another, like a season 3 episode. Oh, yeah, wait, I should point out that before he won the lottery, he was this, like, spastic, hyper nerd guy, like, over-talkative, nervous kind of bundle of nerves character.
Alex!
And then after he won the lottery, he was, like, this too cool for school, you know, always wearing shades and a blazer kind of guy.
Okay.
Yeah. And then I'm watching a later episode, and Kevin appears again. But he's back to the way he was before. He's like spastic, hyper, nervous, nerdy guy.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, and you know he goes with Monk on this to
wait. I have a question.
Investigate what?
I'm sorry if it steps on your toes, but is that explained? His change in attitude.
Let me get to it.
His relapse. Okay. Yep. See, I knew it. I knew I was gonna step on your toe. And
good work. Good work. Done. Yes. Good work. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep failing like you do in everything in life. Everything.
Now I'm drawing blood.
Oh.
Let's rip off the last scene from Key Largo, Mitchell.
Yeah. So this guy shows up again, completely back to normal. You know, nerdy guy. And my first thought is, all right, they probably aired these out of order. They produced them. They had to produce them in this order, but they aired them out of order. And I guess this is explained if you watch them, you know, in the right order. You know, sometimes they don't get everything right in the TV business, you know, yeah. So they forget that this character is out of the picture. And I'm watching the episode as usual, and it seems to make sense. Kevin, in the next scene, Kevin and Monk, and Monk's... I think it's his ex-wife's, or not his ex, I mean, because she's dead. His wife's parents. They're all, the four of them are eating dinner together. Monk is investigating a murder on the set of a TV show that the father is the producer of.
All right.
And in the middle of dinner, the father turns to Kevin and he goes, "So, Kevin, I heard you won the lottery." And I'm like, "Fuck, wait a minute. You blew my theory out of the water."
Oh, dear.
Okay, so he won the lottery. Why is he back to being a spastic nerd and dressing the same way as before and acting the same way as before? And he goes on to explain that he lost all of the lottery money in Vegas to a crooked accountant and in two marriages.
Oh, that's convenient.
Yeah, so apparently writers can just completely destroy this guy's financial victory. Because we need a character to tag along with Monk on this week's episode.
Yes.
You couldn't find a new character. You couldn't just make up a new one. I mean, this was Kevin's second appearance. There's no need to salvage this character. Yeah,
but Alex.
What?
You know what they say about the TV writing business.
What?
It's jungle out there.
I've heard that.
Yeah.
You know what that script could have used?
Mm. This! My fucking voice!
I could have written that much better.
We really need a strong Alex voice here.
Yes.
In Act 3.
Represent the Alexes.
Yeah.
It's just so lazy. Just writing away an entire thing.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah, that's my Monkman for this week.
It's jungle out there.
Thanks, Randy.
I gotta say, you're really tearing down this show from the inside, as it were.
Yeah.
As we journey through in these Monkments.
Well, it's jungle out there.
Thanks. The more I watch it, though... I think the less interesting it becomes to me because maybe this is just because of how TV was in the mid 2000s. This is like 2003, 2004, what I'm watching right now, season 3, I think. There's so much stuff that, and this is actually problematic of a lot of 90s entertainment. There's a lot of people doing stuff that no person would ever do purely for the chance that it might get a laugh.
Here we come. Alex Fraoli, reality police.
I am the reality. No, because it takes me out of the experience. It's a murder mystery. It's all reality and logic. The whole world should be believable, right?
Yes.
But no, you get people being jackasses.
If it is set in the real world, I mean, yeah.
Wait, are you saying San Francisco is not in the real world?
Not what I've seen, buddy. Heyo.
That's pretty good.
The Castro, am I right?
Pride.
Yeah. You say the Met?
I was going to say the Metreon. Is that a place?
Yeah, it's still a place.
All right. And the Met.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. City Target. That's now in the Metreon.
Right.
Yeah.
A couple of stolen 3DSs.
Okay. Yeah.
That's a popular attraction.
Why do you have to dredge that back up?
Because I find it hilarious.
Come on. I don't think you do. I think you secretly find it hurtful.
I do.
You want to hurt me with it.
Yeah, you nailed it.
Okay. Well,
hang on. Hold that thought. There we go.
Ow.
All of my ambassador downloads gone forever.
I know. You weren't going to play Fire Emblem anyway.
Let me hear an apology.
I'm sorry, Ray.
That's good. I guess that's all I'm going to get.
Yep.
Hang on. Wait, let me try again.
I'm sorry,
Alex.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, I'm not going to apologize myself, you jackass.
Step nine!
From outer space. All right.
Wait.
What?
Before we completely dovetail out of Monkments,
it's jungle out there.
I want to ask you something. Are you aware of Little Monk?
What?
I found this out. This was a web series USA started.
Oh my God.
It's about child Adrian Monk and his brother solving crimes in school. School age. Yeah.
What age are we talking? Like elementary school or high school?
He's kind of preteenish.
All right. So I guess we're looking at elementary.
Yeah.
All right.
See. So, yeah, it's a web series. It's a bunch of webisodes.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't have a lot of good memories of any webisodes.
Yeah, it's just, especially something like this. But anyway, if you go to the website, you can't actually watch it, because now I click on, you know, show all clips or show all episodes, and it just goes to a 404.
Oh, no.
So.
I bet they're on YouTube.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
I haven't clicked every link on here, so I don't know.
You know what was a horrible web series, flash series? The Critic.
Yes, I knew you were going to say that.
I feel so bad because on TV that was one of my favorite shows. It was very smart and funny and. But
well, it was years apart.
Yeah. Like, okay.
I mean, of course it's not going to be good. I mean, when you have all those factors in it, you know, web show years apart. You know, can't really get anybody else except Lovitz back, and then it's just crappy.
I should get more Critic drops.
More poison.
I have to say that's they also kind of did that with Alan Partridge.
So oh yeah,
yeah. What's the show called? I'm Alan Partridge.
I don't recall.
Anyway, they recently did like a web series where they brought the character back because now he has a new job at a new radio station. But it's just a real. It's the dead fish as far as I'm concerned.
Well, why don't we do a web series?
Because we're not washed up yet.
Oh.
Right? Right?
Well, I guess we're doing better than I thought.
Yeah, right.
Well, what if somebody out there wants to animate us? We could do the voices. So somebody should do No More Whoppers animated, like the Game Grumps animated.
No,
just take snippets, yes, of us acting out the things that we say in an animated format. What do you say? Let's get Disney on the horn.
Disney, okay.
Maybe something more in our price range.
Yeah, perhaps.
Hanna-Barbera?
Have you seen the trailer for Wreck-It Ralph?
I don't know what that is.
Sounded like me. how much does Hanna-Barbera cost these days?
I don't think they're in business.
Oh, really?
I think they're more. It's more of a brand now for whatever the hell else. I mean,
yeah.
How
about
Warner Brothers
about Ruby Spears?
Dead, I think.
Barnum and Bailey.
That's a circus.
Okay. How about P.T. Barnum and Cat Bailey?
Okay, no.
Rodgers and Hammerstein?
Okay.
Rizzoli and Isles.
Oh, Hanna-Barbera Successors, Warner Brothers Animation, and Cartoon Network Studios.
Ah, okay.
So, yes, now it's just Cartoon Network, basically.
We should have an animated series, right? We're smart.
Yeah.
We're fun. We're fun-loving guys.
We are fun, and we are guys. I think there's better things to animate out in the world.
I can't name one.
What about LSD trips? You know?
Yeah, well, I feel like soon enough medical science is going to have like monitors that can actually see and record those, you know?
Oh, you think so?
You don't think? Yeah, you know.
I suppose so, but why would they build things just to record those?
Because neurologists do that shit. They study the brain in any way possible.
Well, it seems like a big, expensive thing. Just, you know, a lot of advanced technology just to, like, view a trip. I mean,
it seems like shut up.
I mean that's not a field that's, like, awash in money.
No. Oh, but, you know, I'm a fan of MC Chris, who had a long history at William Street and Adult Swim, helping out with animated shows. He just put together an animated series, I think, through a what's it called?
Kickstarter.
There we go. And I realized that the voice of his manager is John Gemberling, and I'd never heard him do anything else until yesterday when he was a guest on How Did This Get Made for the Street Fighter 2 episode. I'm like, as soon as I heard, I'm like, I know that guy's voice. That's MC Chris's manager. And it was. Okay. And then I started researching.
Zero idea who you're talking about.
Okay, well,
I mean, I know MC Chris, but I don't know John Gimberly.
But I looked him up, and apparently, I guess it's not surprising. MC Chris is also very close to the whole UCB community in that scene.
Uh huh.
So that's where that overlap comes from. I'm always giddy when I see overlap in the seemingly unconnected media that I consume.
Yes, of course. That means you're a nerd.
Yes. No shit.
And you'll absorb any sort of trivia you can get your hands on.
Alex.
Yep. For example,
Puerto Rico.
All right. I only. Wait. I got to talk about my video game purchase. Ram, are you ready for this? I'm gonna need your help. It's a video game.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Seventh Dragon 2022.
Yeah.
Now, keep in mind, not 2022, but 2020 hyphen Roman numeral 2.
Yeah. It's 2020 Tuesday here on No More Whoppers.
It's not great.
Really? But the first one was?
The first one was pretty good. This feels exactly like an expansion pack.
Yeah, okay. That doesn't surprise me.
It feels like they like a Final Fantasy 13 2 situation. They had so much stuff left over from the first one, they just made a second one.
Yeah.
Threw it all to it
actually if they are going to make it hyphen 2, yeah, it probably is exactly what that.
Yeah. Okay. Even the main theme song, the vocal theme song sounds like a first draft of the first game's theme song.
Oh, ew.
It's like we got to rework this.
Oh, let's just throw in the demo version.
All right.
Let's give us the first tape they sent us.
Yeah. Now, the game itself is almost identical to the first one. It's just a lot of palette-swapped stuff, characters and monsters, and some areas are entirely reused.
Great.
The job classes are all the same. I think there's one or two new job classes, but you don't get the second one until later.
They are really taken after Final Fantasy.
I know. But you know what? I really don't mind it because I did enjoy the first one.
Yes, okay.
I do like now that you can palette swap your characters when you make a character. You can choose from up to three different palettes.
Wow.
I know. Shut up. I had such a color boner for Dragon Quest and Final Fantasy on the Nintendo. Just the idea of palette swap monsters representing this monster hierarchy. I loved the idea of that. And so I like changing. Like, I even like palette swap ninjas in a fighting game, for example. Or NBA Jam. The game is all right. But my biggest complaint here, and this was sort of present in the first one, is that every American character is a complete asshole.
Oh, of course.
And I don't know if this is like just the Japanese aversion to anything relating to war at all, or if it's, I don't know, somebody at Sega just hates America.
Okay, what do you mean with the war thing?
Well, let me.
Is there war in a game? In the game?
No. I mean how it's this view that all Americans are warmongering animals.
Oh well, yeah.
Which shows up from time to time.
Uh huh.
This was partially present in the first game, where the president of. A little bit. I haven't killed anyone recently.
Yeah.
This is partially present in the first game, where the president of the United States, you know, when Japan is under attack from dragons, they call up the president of the United States, and they're like, "You have to help us. It's your job as the president of the United States." And he's like, "Sorry, suckers, you're on your own." And that's that. Like,
what does he actually say?
We're busy with the dragons here in our own country. Please worry about your own country.
That's not that bad, I think.
I know, well, but everyone at Murakumo HQ, the Japanese agency that fights dragons, is really pushing this, you know, you have to help us because you're so powerful. It's, I don't know, it seems to run the opposite of the usual stance that you hear that's like, hey, America, stop policing the world. But suddenly when there's dragons around, it's like, America, come help us out.
Or how about, hey, Japan, stop acting so weak.
Yeah.
How about that, huh? Yeah, I just flipped it around on you, motherfucker.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
And then I thought, the first Seventh Dragon, I think, was released before.
Just move along, thank you.
Yeah. The first Seventh Dragon was released before the disaster in 2011. And if you remember, there was this joint operation between the U.S. military and the Japanese Jiaitai, or SDF, Self-Defense Force. Mm-hmm. And it was called Operation Tomodachi or something to that effect. And right. we kicked in a lot of manpower and helped look for people.
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right, that's got to do something in the public's eyes to, you know, show that maybe we're not a bunch of gorilla monsters. And then in 2022, every single U.S. agent or soldier is just a raging asshole in every way. And it's perplexing to me because okay, it's what?
The entire game is not rooted in reality.
I know that, but the countries are.
No, I don't. They're probably not.
This is only an issue. This is only an issue because I'm very sensitive to the whole idea of my culture being misrepresented in Japanese culture.
I can sympathize with that, but also it's science fiction.
I know, but it's not. Fantasy. It's not a science fiction make-believe country of America that's based on a real place.
Avatar is just as bad.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, you're right.
It's made here. Well, you know, made by a guy from
I don't know. Sure. Yeah. Isn't it? What are the odds that a man named James Cameron would become a director?
It's
That's amazing.
Dad, sit down.
Let me give you some examples here of what I'm talking about. There's these two characters in the game. First of all, I want to say every character in the game so far speaks flawless Japanese. Even the American characters, when they're shitting on Japan, they do it in perfect Japanese.
Yes. Well, I'm sure soldiers who learned Arabic do the same thing.
Sure. And it starts, like, you meet these two twins, a boy and a girl with blue hair. They're, you know, they help you out. They jump in and save your butt, like in the first tower or whatever. And then, you know, they bring you back to HQ and you're thanking them. And they're like, man, you Japanese are so weak. And everybody in the party is like, aren't you Japanese? And they're like, no, we were born in America. Our parents are Japanese, but we were born in America, so we're American. And they're like, what?
Well, that's an extra layer there.
Yeah. It's like, so you have to act like an asshole because you were born there? I mean...
No, okay.
Like, racially, you guys are exactly the same.
Yeah, but that just sounds like the Japanese view of Japanese Americans.
Right? Yeah, that's true, yeah. That there's no such thing, yeah.
You can't be Japanese, you're in America. Yeah. You speak English.
Exactly. It's all connected to this, the core of Japanese, sociology is you're in the club. You know... Yes. All the things about Japanese culture because you were born here and your family's Japanese. You're in the club. Anybody else is outside the club. It's impossible for you to ever penetrate it and ever know anything about Japan at all. And then there's a scene, there's a bunch of scenes where those two, you know, quote unquote, American agents and their American unit are attacking dragons and stuff. And every soldier in the unit is just a complete cockface. It's all, hey, you Japanese, stay out of our way.
Yeah.
Like, you're on the fucking same side, everybody. There's goddamn dragons everywhere. Just work together and kill the dragons. Let's do that.
I think it's like that in some of the Yakuza games, also by Sega.
Yeah.
You have the foreign soldiers around Okinawa, for example.
Yeah.
And they're also just kind of like oafish jerks.
And they all say, shit, when you punch them.
Yes, yes.
All right. Awesome.
That sort of attitude is not isolated to Japan either, because any...
I know.
Any place that we occupy... is, you know, going to view us as a bunch of oafish jerks.
That's true. I try not to get political at all on this show because that's not what it's about. No. This is something that I have observed as an American citizen living in Japan, consuming Japanese media.
Did I tell you I'm Italian?
Sure.
Don't forget that.
Are you saying I should play the Italian localizations of popular video games?
I think you should
for 10
just
and
play...
10. And no, do voice no. it? No.
And do some in the voice. Hey, no more.
I'm asking you.
Yes. No. No, I just mean play up your Italian-ness in public in Japan.
Oh,
distance
sure.
Distance yourself from America as much as possible.
I'm down with the U.S.
Well, I mean, sure, to yourself, but I mean, your public face would be more of a European.
Ah, yeah. I just think it's a
What? Good excuse to smoke more.
I guess. Molto bene. I just think it's a very lazy way to write characters, especially yes. American characters. It's just make them all complete blockheaded assholes.
Well, I don't mean to be further reductivist about it, but it's also a JRPG.
Yeah, that's true. I know.
It's a Japanese RPG. But I guess from the sound of it, a cheapish sort of semi-sequel.
Yeah. I was just so excited because I really did enjoy the first one. I thought it was not necessarily unique, but it does that Japanese thing where they take something very simple and uncomplicated, but they do it very well.
Yeah.
Which is sort of a cultural point of pride, which I enjoy in the country.
You can just call this episode that, though. They do this Japanese thing.
Now, here's the cherry on top. I'd like to rattle off some of the names of these soldiers. Raymond, if you'll indulge me.
Absolutely, yes.
All right. As usually happens, Japan has this stock reserves of foreigner names that it goes to for everything.
May I guess at least three?
I've only got six. I don't know if you're going to hit any overlap, but let's try. Go for it.
Oh, I'm going to try.
I think you can get at least one.
I'll get two. How about that?
All right.
Better? Okay. James?
No.
Patrick.
No.
Damn it. Okay. Go ahead.
All right. Here we go. Dave.
Okay.
Bobby.
Yes.
That's a favorite. Fred.
Right.
Jake.
Mm-hmm.
Will.
Yeah.
Oh, really? And here's one. Here's one from out of left field. Godwin. I don't know.
Does he invoke anything in particular?
I don't think so.
Any particular laws?
He's got God and Win right in his name, though, so he's got to be pretty powerful.
Yeah.
Now, they do that thing where Americans are referred to by their first name.
Right.
Which, again, is not a thing if you're meeting somebody that you don't know or someone in a professional capacity.
Godwin-san.
But it's like, I think they're applying this, you know, oh, our names are reversed, so that means you guys must use first names all the time with everybody. No, we don't.
Oh, yeah.
Stop it. And it does kind of make all the American characters sound childlike because everybody's using only their first name. It's this like military techno babble too. It's like Bobby, cover me. All right, Jake.
Yeah. What the? Yeah. I think I've noticed that before too. When it is like in a military context, it's still guys calling each other by their first name.
Yeah.
It's just like no, it's not. That's not how it goes. Just use like Martinez or something for Christ's sake.
Yeah.
That's how they do it.
Yeah. Hudson. There's a good one.
Actually, I would like to see. Yeah. I don't know exactly how they treat the localizations of Call of Duty, but I mean, they must at least use the last name.
I could ask my friend Dallas.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's big into those games in Japanese.
I think they did get better with localizing them, so.
All right. Anyway, that's my beef with Seven Dragon 2022. It's a fun, quickly crapped out expansion pack, but it's not great.
And how much did you spend on it?
5,300 yen, because I wanted the pre-order bonus, which is a soundtrack, 6 tracks of music, and 40 voice actor tracks.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So, wait, it's just
their fuck,
lines,
I should have made those into drops. Hang on, wait, right there. I believe it's the voice actors.
Is it a drama?
No. It's the voice samples from the game. Cause
yes, okay.
When you create a character, you choose their voice.
Who uses that? Who needs that?
I don't know. It was a huge selling point. It's like all these famous anime voice actors.
No. Who needs that? Who actually needs it and uses it? I don't get it.
I don't know.
Why do... Does anyone actually give a shit? Do any of these nerds actually give a shit?
I don't think so.
About, oh my god. It's just because it's there, right? Oh, it's like archival, right?
Yeah.
Dumb sons of bitches.
I don't know. It's like, hey, we got some extra time. Let's put all this crap on the disc. And you know what?
She sounds so cute here. Tomoe.
Anata, mezawari na no yo.
Oh, yeah.
I just threw them all into soundboard.
Yeah, great.
Probably a mistake.
Yes.
Katazukechau yo!
Oh, wait, we can have some fun here.
Sugu ni sugu!
Okay, that's...
はじめしてやる。なめるなよ。
Jeez.
I know, this guy's angry.
放っておけるか?
Jesus. Sit down.
さあ、はじめるぞ。
Oh, God. I think I've seen this hentai.
宴の支度だ!
Oh, here come the tentacles.
Oh, Grandpa, stop it.
Oh, God. Wow, you made her sound even cuter.
Oh, God. Now we'll listen to them in that tunnel. All right. I think this should be the new format of the show.
I'm going to veto.
Why? Are you sure?
Scary this?
On stage!
I'm sorry, I won't do it again.
Don't say it! Gashimasen!
Alright, okay. You're gonna wear out the buzzer. We only get a few of those a year. Anyway, that's the story of Seventh Dragon 2022. Don't buy it.
Jerk store!
Shall we take a break before skidding into fan fun?
I think yes, yes.
All right, we'll be right back.
God. Folks, we're back. It's No More Whoppers. What do you have to say about that?
I got some coffee. Raymond, it seems like you have a drink.
I got something to drink, yeah.
Good. All right. Folks, let's talk fan fun.
Fan fun.
We love the fan fun.
That's where we talk about your name.
In a good way.
Maybe you like the Facebook page.
Possibly.
And then you send us stories and then money.
Maybe. It.
And you get a dollar
for a second.
Wait, no, you get a second for a dollar. And then there's some other things. We hope it doesn't offend you.
It might.
But we like it anyway. And, oh, God.
What?
Fan fun time. What's up first?
Oh, wait a minute. Hang on. Let me try something really annoying.
Oh, yeah. That's what I want to hear.
No, I'm setting up a soundboard so that all of the voice clips play simultaneously.
Oh, no.
We're going to see how awful this sounds. Ready?
I'm going to bet pretty awful.
Here we go. Sounds like Tokyo Station.
Yeah. Or an anime con.
Wow, that was completely just a block on my waveform. That may be that's probably unusable.
I heard it okay. I mean, I could tell there were voices.
Jesus Christ. All right.
I'm still going to fire you.
Damn it. This is all I've got.
You should have thought about that.
Don't send me back to the cannery.
You made these terrible choices.
Oh, well, you got a new buzzer at least. All right.
Yeah, same one.
Folks, unfortunately, we do not have donors this week. No donor boner.
Exactly. Yeah.
So, get on that. We could use some more bucks.
Well, they must have been putting it all into Retronauts and Scroll.
You're right. That's right. You guys get a week off. We don't mind. You're kicking into the other stuff.
Yeah.
That Ray does.
Yeah, but not Alex.
Why don't you throw a couple K my way?
You're never going to regret this, Ray.
Yeah, Alex needs to go on more dates.
Thanks, yes!
There's mini golf, there's the bar, the bar, there's ice cream.
The golf
there's
bar.
There's the bar.
Ice cream bar. Mini golf ice cream. A carousel.
Shrimp gumbo.
We're going to go straight to Facebook likes. Now, because we recorded late last week, we had an excess of likes last week. That means we have a drought of likes this week. Only four, jeez. Raymond. Only four.
Oh, okay.
No. That's it's enough, I guess. We're going to do our best.
The world. Yeah.
All right. Are you ready for this?
I'm always ready.
Here we go. Facebook likes for the week of April 28th? Sure.
Why not?
Here it goes. God damn it.
It has to be an act.
No, it's not. I breathed in too quickly and my throat got dry and I coughed. All right, here we go for real. Son of John Madden and Heather Gladden, Dan McPadden. When Donald Trump has a meeting in Ohio, he just looks at his pilot and says, David, Cleveland. This jury finds you guilty on three counts of Stephen larceny. And Luke Wilson's brother stars as the United Nations building in UNON. Thanks, everybody.
Oh, God. Yep, pretty good.
Doing my best.
You do a good Trump.
Thanks. Just two words.
Yes. Well, well, it's like me doing two words as Huell Hauser. I mean, if I did just that, it'd be great.
All right, thanks everyone for liking the Facebook page. And you know what else we have?
I think I do.
What is it?
Do you want me to just say it, or should I just go ahead and...
Got a Pikachu, but he's only level 2. What choices am I left with today? Game Boy comes to work with me, grinding near the coffee bean. Starbucks sucks anyway.
I was going to say, it's Overnerds.
It is them.
Yeah, as the theme song told you.
Yes.
I mean, not directly, but I mean, that's what it represents.
Yes, thank you.
Overnerds.
We're ready for Overnerds.
Okay, yeah.
If you'll come right this way. Transform and roll out, motherfucker! Oh, man, my soundboard is clipping all over the place because I messed with those voice things.
Yeah.
I'm going to restart it real quick. Hi, Ray!
Hi, Al.
How's it going?
I'm okay.
You know, we got two Overnerds this week.
Okay.
From a Scot, by which I mean... His name is Scott. He's not from Scotland.
Okay, yeah.
And from a Luke, who is not from Scotland either, but he is from
and
Ireland.
And a Yid.
Yes. And one from a very filthy...
Redacted.
Is it really my fault?
Were you raised that way?
Yeah, I was raised by...
Redacted.
All right.
No more Whoppers.
I was raised by no more Whoppers.
Wait, wrong one.
What?
That is so Alex.
I was raised by my dad. And my mom. And no more Whoppers. That would be a good idea. We should sell like t-shirts for infants. Like they have ones that say I love my grandpa or whatever. I love no more Whoppers. why does that baby have a no more Whoppers t-shirt on? I don't know, he loves it. Puts him to sleep every night.
That's a picture frame from a baby picture of one of my nieces. I love my grandma.
Oh, yep.
Yeah. We do that.
Yeah, that's an experiment. If we have any pregnant listeners, try playing them No More Whoppers while they're still in the womb.
Wait. How about this on the shirt or thing?
What?
I don't like Italians.
People might take that the wrong way.
Yeah, but it's a baby. No one would get that offended.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Yes! Oh, God. All right, our first Overnerd comes from Scott Lowe.
Familiar?
Yes, we played Final Fantasy XI. Yeah, wow, both of these come from people I've played MMOs with. Pretty exciting.
Hi,
oh, God. Pretty exciting. He writes, this past weekend,
This
past weekend, my wife and I attended the local comic book convention. While browsing one of the vendors, I hear an older man call out to me, Ken has no business fighting the Hulk. Hadoukens wouldn't even singe him. It turns out the owner of the stall had taken offense at a Marvel vs. Capcom t-shirt I happened to be wearing that day. I tried to explain that it was just a game and none of it was that realistic to begin with, but he wasn't having any of it. I finally had to just turn to my wife and pretend that she wanted to look elsewhere to escape him.
Wow.
Thanks, Scott. I think this is very similar to our conversation earlier about people choosing to misunderstand Kickstarter.
Possibly,
Or, it's nerds who have to say something... either contrarian or they just have to be negative in some way, and that's that. Yeah. It's
I will say though, that's like an OG Overnerd.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, you know, from before even our time. That's like just classic nerd stuff, you know. Of course someone would say something like that, right?
Yeah. Wait, I still don't know what you mean.
What he said, Ken can't beat the Hulk. Or
Yeah. No, no, the wording is my favorite. Ken has no business fighting the Hulk.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah, even better.
Really?
Yeah.
Come on.
It has that extra pinch of Asperger's in it.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Ken has no business fighting the Hulk. You know? Oh, boy.
This also reminds me of that that YouTube video somebody did. It's like an hour long. It's like Superman versus Goku, who would win? Like, fuck it, yeah. What are you doing?
Not as bad as Dead Fantasy,
no,
though.
No, shut up, sit down, what are you doing? Yeah, Dead Fantasy, we even talked about that before on the show.
Yeah,
like, episode
so, yeah.
11 or something.
Yeah. Like, aren't you fucking sick of that, people?
Yeah.
And creator?
Seriously. I don't know, I don't go for that who would win stuff.
No.
Because really... my position is, who gives a shit?
That does remind me, okay, so, you know, there's a new fighting game with DC Comics characters.
Yeah.
Made by the Mortal Kombat people.
Yes.
And the TV commercial, or one of them at least, features Jason Mewes and Kevin Smith being wacky in it, and just like, you know, because I guess, you know, they're comic book nerds.
Yeah.
So it's them really overacting.
Wait, Jason Mraz?
No, Mewes.
Oh, who's that?
Jay.
Who's that? Oh. Okay.
Jiminy Christmas.
They should have gotten Jason.
Anyway, Morris. Yeah, it's a little bit hard to watch.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, but that reminded me of that.
Now, didn't they also made like a Mortal Kombat versus DC, right?
That's right.
And how did that work? Like, I mean, fatalities, like you can show Batman getting diced up?
No, it's not very gory.
Oh.
I mean, there's blood in it, I believe, but there's no real decapitations or anything like that.
All right.
Not from any side, really. Like, even the Joker, who could, you know, should be as psychotic as a Mortal Kombat character, really isn't even that bad.
Oh, boy. For some reason, even in the fighting game universe, I could never get into any of those crossover fights, like franchise versus franchise. It's, because it's like, my first thought is, who asked for this? Why? Why, like, why do we want to see this? Go back to making the game with all the characters from the game.
Yeah. Well, I do like the Marvel vs. Capcom games just for Capcom characters.
Yeah?
Like, I sort of like seeing Phoenix Wright fight and stuff like that.
I wouldn't mind, like an all Capcom game.
Yeah.
But, I mean, why? I don't know.
Well...
And I'm not
that and it didn't work.
I'm not saying they're bad games or that they're not fun, because I did enjoy Marvel vs. Capcom. I'm saying aesthetically, it's very weird to me to see two franchises mixing just because there's a fighting tournament.
Yeah, I'm not going to say that it's not weird to have Marvel characters there with them.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't really make a lot of sense. Same with DC and Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
But what about Smash Brothers?
I love Smash Brothers.
Okay.
Because it's keeping it in the family. It's all Nintendo properties and stuff.
But Sonic is in it. Snake.
It's fine, Ray.
Okay.
Ray burgers.
No, is it fine with you?
I feel like a burger.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it's fine with me. What about the No More Whoppers fighting game? Alex, Ray, the Jellyman.
Jellyman has not actually been defined as a corporeal body.
Clooney Tunes.
No, that's not.
Rosemary Clooney? How about it's just a bunch of Alexes, like Alex Jones?
Right. No, just palette swapped Alex Frioli.
Okay. And then you can unlock Robot Alex, what is it?
Alex Tron,
yeah.
Jesus. Alex Tron 5000.
Thanks.
Get it right. Oh, and of course, video game Heel Hauser.
Yeah.
Oh, Heel Hauser and Smash Brothers would be good.
Right. All your favorite levels are there. The Island. Japan.
Japan at night.
Japan at night.
And of course has great breast physics.
Yeah. All right. Round one. Fight.
Yeah. Songs by Randy Newman.
Yes, let's get them.
You got a friend in me.
Yeah, we got friendships. You can play as Steve.
Steve!
Round two.
Let's go back to yesterday.
Oh, and a deep and complex combo system.
I don't care how many Dago, Guinea, Wop, Greaseball, Goombas come out of the woodwork.
Look, was that like a 5-hit combo?
Weren't we doing a show?
All right, we have one more Overnerd from a Luke Maxwell, with whom I play the fun Dragon Quest 10 in 10. Download it today on CD and cassette.
God, why isn't...
How you doing?
I don't like you making all these friends. When is somebody going to submit an Overnerd that I know?
Luke Maxwell writes, my friend
wants to play either with me. No, he doesn't anything with me. Well, there's a minute Overnerd. All right.
My friend.
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
My friend Big Steve spent all his money buying a replica katana from Japan days before his girlfriend's birthday. Needless to say, she wasn't impressed. When she confronted him about it, Big Steve told her that, it's totally cool, baby. I named her after you anyway. Spare a thought for the roaming samurai Big Steve and his trusty steel, Louise. Keep up the great work, Luke Maxwell. I like everything about this story. I like the fact that there's a guy named Big Steve.
Mm-hmm.
That he named his sword after his girlfriend.
Right. Or B.B. King's guitar.
Right. That's true. and that Luke refers to it as his trusty steel.
Yes.
I'm a big fan of that. Yeah. I also like the fact that he bought this very close to her birthday as if it's some kind of gift.
Uh-huh.
Like... Look, I can protect you now, baby. I know, like, he's probably Irish and doesn't talk like that, but I like to do that.
Yes, he's some sort of
I don't do a
rockabilly
good...
guy.
Yes, he's the one rockabilly in Ireland.
Yes. Last of a dying breed. Last of the Mohicans sort of thing.
Damn it, Louise!
That sounded just prospectory.
Oh. I don't need to strike gold when I have Werther's original.
No, that's okay. That's just something else. Yeah, Alex, I know you have a story about this.
I do?
Related to this.
What?
Tell us the Dreamcast story.
What's the Dreamcast story? What, that I think I told that before.
I want to hear it again.
Why? I received a Dreamcast from a girl for Christmas in high school and dumped her the next day.
Yep.
Because I had already decided weeks before that I was going to dump her and go out with another girl. That didn't work out.
What didn't?
Everything.
The other girl?
No, like 1996 to about 2003. Didn't work out.
Oh,
Let's
okay.
say that.
All right. So you didn't get with the other girl.
Well, yes, we did, but it lasted like a week. That was the worst part, is that in my mind, I'm like, I want to rig up with her, but I should probably wait till after Christmas. That would be polite. And then I wait the day after Christmas. Like, New Year's hadn't even come yet.
Why would you even consider that?
Well, the other girl was really cute.
Ugh.
And she liked games more.
Stop thinking with your dick.
I'm not! Well, wait a minute, hang on. Yes! Yeah, you're right. And then the camera pans over and I'm getting advice from Dick Cavett. Thanks, Dick.
Or confusingly, Mike Ditka.
Alright, thank you both of you, Scott and Luke, for your Overnerds. And our Overnerd, well, our reserves are dry. We could use some more folks. If you got any, send them on it. What?
Can we call those two Skluk?
I like that. Thanks, Skluk.
Yeah. It also, another Hollywood power couple.
It also sounds like a short name for a muscle, like if you're at the gym, like you're working on your skluks.
I sprained my skluks.
Oh. I've got this powder that works wonder on your skluks.
Oh, okay. Really need to work on my delts and my skluks today. But tomorrow's a leg day.
I went mountain climbing and I really tore my ass.
No, posterior.
Oh, sorry.
Jeez. Could you learn some of the gym lingo, please?
I always listen to gym lingo in the mornings. You're listening to Jim.
Almost like, the end of the show. Just hang in there, Ray. It's almost the end of the show. Deep breath. It's almost over.
Lingo.
It's like a child, Ray. He's just going to wear himself out. It'll be over soon.
Where's my bottle?
He'll be on the floor in a blanket as soon enough.
Caller, you're on the air.
I'm Banjo.
There aren't even words in English for how much I hate you. We have to look into like Eskimo languages.
Yes, they do have 24 words for hate.
Yes. So is that fan fun?
I think it is. Yeah, that was fan fun.
Okay, it was a good fan fun. As even though it wasn't like a lot of it, and we didn't get any donors. Still pretty good. You know what? Quality, not quantity. That's what we like around here.
All right. All right. I'll hand it off to you. Do your thing there where you lied, everybody.
All right. Well, that's fan fun, and I guess that is the end of the show.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah. Thanks, everybody, for listening. You can go to our website, nomorewhoppers.tumblr.com. There you can find our donate button, and you should probably click on it this time.
Yeah.
I'm asking you. give us money and Alex will tell your life story. And then you can also go to our Facebook page, facebook.com/nomorewhoppers. Like that page and Alex will, have some fun with your name. It makes me laugh and that's important. And also a note about Facebook likes, Alex.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if this is if somebody at Facebook is bungling everything, but... there are some likes that either of us may be unable to see unless we are actually friends with that person. I think it's some kind of a privacy setting. So, in any event, if you have liked the Facebook page and have not yet heard your name, please drop us a line on Twitter or Facebook or email or whatever.
Yes. People have said things like that, but it was kind of easily fixed. I mean, it was a different situation.
Yes.
But there may be a silent majority out there.
Yes. So if you feel like we're ignoring you, we are not. No. Nope. Not deliberately.
No, we have to get a sense of who you are first.
You've got before. A friend in us.
For the time being.
Yes.
Overnerd stories of extreme nerdery.
Send them
please,
in.
If you can model them after that sort of...
Yes.
If from those that we just heard... Those are great. Yes. Those are great models.
Thanks to Scott and Luke for keeping it short and tight.
Yeah.
Like a little linebacker. What's going on?
That's why you trust in playing FF11 with him.
That's right. Well, and DQ10 with Luke.
Yeah, the MMOs. Those
Thanks.
Games you play on the computer.
You playing the MMOs? Which MMOs are you playing? What is that, like a dragon? What do you got, like a sword? That's always my favorite approach. Like, doing that voice is just name the most basic thing in that game. Oh, you got a shield? What is that, like a boot?
Oh, you're playing Horde?
Hey, on some kind of integrated server?
Oh, yeah, instances. Yeah.
Yeah, my mom's a night elf.
Yeah, I'm LFP. Hey, I'm just charging my 2-hour over here. Too much? Okay.
What are you talking about? Hit points? All right.
We're on iTunes. Be nice to us on iTunes. Reviews, written or just stars, are fine. Make sure they're high and positive. I mean, don't write them high. Let's make sure we write some sober reviews. Make sure you come from a genuine place of like. And, you know. Be nice to us.
Thank you. I like that term, genuine like. Let's go with that all the time for everything in the world.
I like you.
What are we talking? Like a greater manticore?
And Twitter. No more whoppers. Stuff's on there. Stuff's also on our personal Twitters.
That's right. Mine's Pituhi. P-I-T-O-H-U-I.
Named after the gland.
That's right. No, Ray.
I have fun. And I'm RDB AAA. Also listen to X and 10, which I guess will be 10 and 10.
And I can promise you I'm going to do observant Guido character now, because I'm in love with that.
Okay.
What do you got, like a cookery?
Chilling vision of things to come.
Have you ever seen Colossus, the Forbin Project? No. It's a movie. It's a Cold War movie where a supercomputer nukes the entire world. That's basically what my life is going to look like.
Yes.
Yeah, just ashes everywhere.
Yeah.
And characters.
Alex, has been fun.
As always.
Maybe a little too fun this time.
Never too fun with Ray.
But everybody else, keep your nose clean, and we'll see you next week. Gold subscribers, stick around after the show. We brainstorm new names for our No More Whoppers house band, formerly known as the John Spencer Texas Fertilizer Explosion.
Got a Pikachu, but got a Pikachu, but got a Pikachu, but
Kickstarter!
We have fun. All right, are you ready? Ah, I thought we had fun.